Lewis Cass in their road navies, navy shorts, navy jerseys, white numbers trimmed in red, and the Rochester Zebras in their home whites. White shorts, white jerseys, black numbers trimmed in gold. Tony Stasiak, I'm David Musselman. We are ready for the varsity contest. A little late, I know. The JV game went in triple overtime. Lewis Cass held on to that game 47-45. Aldridge and Kennedy to jump. And the tip is up and controlled by Hadley in the Lewis Cass backcourt. Hadley inside the arc. He's down low to middle. Turnaround jumper over Odell's in and out. No good. Ball tipped around it. Alec Holland comes out of there with it. Holland in runs, but he leans his leg dribble. Works against Kiesling in the backcourt to Odell. Odell works against Watterson. Pull-up jumper from 10 feet is good.
Good sign from John to go inside, not settle for that jumper, but take a couple more dribbles and make it a great shot.
Good-looking stroke by John Odell early in this basketball game. Rochester strikes first, and here comes a little bit of half-court trap by the Rochester Zebras. Down the road to Aldridge. His jumper over corner is good, and we're tied at two with 30 seconds gone in the opening quarter. Quickly, Rochester the other way. Who played last night? We're in a track meet right now.
It's a 18-year-old kid.
Oh, they can run all day long.
At least they think they can.
Alec Holland up top against the man-to-man defense and works against Austin Kiesling. And now to Garrick on the left wing. Alec Garrick backs it out and sets up the offense. Picks up his dribble now to the volleyball line. Now sends right wing to Holland. Down low to Kennedy. Kennedy against Aldridge. Turner being double-teamed now. And he is going to be fouled on the reach-in by Kiesling. And, boy, I tell you what, once a big man gets that ball down there around his waist, anybody has the shot at it.
Yeah, you want to keep the ball up nice and high and keep it away from those little guys. Zebras had a nice little wrinkle there. They put John Odell on the post, which is I think, a good move because he's got a shorter guy guarding him. They just missed the look.
Seth Korn behind the arc on the right side. Now gives to Holland. He'll set up the offense between the rings at the volleyball line. 2-2 here with 6:50 to play in the first quarter. Rochester the basketball. Kennedy shot over Miller. No good. Aldridge skies for the board and grabs and gives now to Hadley. Lewis Cass runs to our right. Watterson now just inside the arc on the right side. Gives to Aldridge. Aldridge's finger off and no good off the front of the rim. Rebound by Miller and Lewis Cass. He travels.
Another wrinkle by Cass is John Odell's being face guarded by number 34.
Watterson.
Yeah, he doesn't care what's happening on the weak side of the floor. He's face guarding, trying to deny Odell the ball.
So it's almost like a box and one.
Yeah, you're playing man-to-man principles with everybody else, but they're playing regular man-to-man, and Watterson is just not leaving for any reason.
Alec Holland with the basketball. Almost has it stolen. Gives to Garrick, and he loses it off his fingertips and out of bounds. And it'll go back to Lewis Cass on the Rochester turnover. 6:22 to play first quarter. Rochester and Lewis Cass tied at two.
Zebras in a 2-2-1 half-court trap.
Hadley, right in the middle of the floor, crosses the timeline to Kiesling. Backdoor pass to Watterson. Watterson over Kennedy is short. And Garrick skies to the board and grabs it and loses it out of bounds. They're going to say last touch then by Lewis Cass. And Rochester will keep possession with 6:12 to play in the first quarter.
Nice find for Zebra fans. They went right at Kennedy underneath, and he held his position and did not foul.
Yeah, there's the key. I think it's double team. Alec Holland picks up his dribble, gives to Cord. Now down low to Garrick. And Luke Kennedy's going to be whistled for the three-second call. You know, there are times, Tony, you don't see that call very often, and then all of a sudden you see a plethora of it.
Yeah, in that case, Luke was away from the ball. He wasn't even, you know, trying to post up. There really was no reason to be in the lane, just wasn't aware where he was at.
Aldridge against Kennedy, kicks it out to Miller, fires a long three from the left baseline, is in and out, no good, and Kennedy grabs the board. Luke now gives to Holland. Rochester runs to our left. We're tied at two. Odell, 4-3, right side. Nope. Oh, the glass is good. I didn't think there was any chance that thing was going. That thing hit the side of the backboard and went in.
Did not see his mouth move, so do not think he called bank.
Rochester up 5-2. Again, Lewis Cass has it wide open. Is Watterson down low. Watterson over the defense is good. 5-4, Rochester by one. 5.5 to play in the first quarter.
Zebras have to remember to close the back door in that trap. Cass is spreading them out, and they're forgetting about that weak side baseline cut.
That's the second time already in this first, early in this first quarter, Lewis Cass had the back door wide open. 5-4, Rochester. The Zebras with the basketball going to our left. Garrick works against Kiesling in the man-to-man defense. Tried to thread the needle to Korn. Picked off then by Miller. Gives to Hadley. Hadley brings it up the floor. Now sets up shot between the rings and the volleyball line. Now works right corner to Kiesling. Yeah. Kiesling. Then left side to Hadley behind the arc. Back to Kiesling. Now to Hadley between the rings. Man-to-man defense by the Rochester Zebras. Hadley crossover dribble is fouled as he goes to the paint. And I believe that's going to be an Alec Holland. We'll wait and see.
That's Alec's first and team's first. One of the big stories of the first half last night, Zebras got in foul trouble as a team, not just Kennedy, but as a team. Need to stay out of foul trouble tonight.
Watterson left side and in the corner to Kiesling. Kiesling against Garrick, and we're going to have a foul down low. Is that going to be against Kennedy? I think he will be on the push.
As what often happens, you get the second guy. Aldridge is pushing. Luke was trying to hold his ground and establish position, got those hands in the back, and they got the second guy, not the first.
So Rochester with their second team foul, the no-look pass inside to Hadley, and he does a great job, who caught the basketball virtually under the rim and for somehow got it to go with the left hand. And Lewis Cass now up 6-5. Here 4.5 to play in the first quarter, and Alec Holland loses it out of bounds. They're going to say last touch, though, by Hadley. It'll stay with the Zebras baseline. Alec Holland gets the inbounds pass from Odell. Holland now in the paint, cut off by the defense. Outside of Garrick, between the circles at the volleyball line. Works against Kiesling in the man-to-man defense. Now to Holland. Holland around the pick in the paint, cut off by the defense. Now looks back door to Garrick on the baseline, now to Kennedy. Luke with the basketball against Aldridge. Top to Holland, now right wing to Korn. Seth Korn drives, throws a shot up off the glass. No good. Miller with the board. It gives to Hadley. King's running to the right. Lewis Cass up 5 to make that 6-5. Now Kiesling. Kiesling in the wing at the free throw line in the paint. Push from behind. He's fouled. Oh, no, he's going to be called for travel. I beg your pardon.
Yeah. I think there was a foul, but the steps, you know, it's kind of an awkward move. Sometimes if it looks awkward, the referees default and call the travel.
Yeah.
I mean, if you get a chance to look back, yeah, maybe he didn't drag that foot. But sometimes if it looks awkward, that's enough to get the call.
3:45 to play first quarter. Lewis Cass by 1 at 6-5. Carter Screeton will check in to the next dead ball opportunity, which is right now as Hadley knocks the basketball out of bounds. It's going to stay with Rochester right in front of the Kings bench.
You know, another option with Odell being face guarded, you can do is you can use the guy who's being face guarded as your screener because his defender's not going to help.
Right.
So that's another way to kind of get other guys involved is use John as a screener and get some guys open that way.
So Alec Holland gets a breather as Carter Screeden comes in for him for his first action tonight. He passes to Garrick, who passes right wing to Kennedy. Kennedy holds against Aldridge, who sides back in the lane. Now to Garrick. Baseline to Carter Screeden. Screen against Hadley. In the paint, loses the basketball, but I believe Hadley's going to be called on the reach-in. So it'll say Rochester basketball, 3:21 to play in the first quarter. Again, the Zebras up 6-5.
Hadley second, Cass team second foul. Or sorry, first. Hadley's first, team second for Cass.
Odell baseline left. We'll look to get it in over Watterson. Does so to Odell. Or make that to Korn. His 15-footer is no good. Ball being tipped around. Watterson comes out of there with it. Gives to Hadley. Cass runs to our right. Hadley right through the center circle. Picked up by Screeden in the volleyball line. Works right wing to Kiesling. Kiesling against Garrick. Down to Miller, top of the key. Bounce pass left wing to Hadley. Hadley a couple of dribbles. Now in the paint. And he is fouled going to the lane by Screeton, and it's going to be out of bounds to Lewis Cass underneath their own basket.
Yeah, Carter's holding his hands up, and his hands were up at the end of the possession, but right before that, his hands were on the guy's back
check,
and he tried to dislodge him.
Aldridge in the left corner to Hadley, top of the key. Now to Kiesling. Kiesling fires a three from left baseline, draws barely iron. Miller comes out of there with the basketball. The putback is good. Jordan Miller has his first two of the contest, I believe, and it's 8-5. Lewis Cass is up with 2:45 to play in the opening quarter.
Cass has four different scorers score 2 points each already.
Odell's floater to the lane is off the glass and good. Yeah, we're talking about balance, that's it. Rochester cuts the Cass lead to 1. It's 8-7. 2.5 to play in the first quarter. Hadley around the defense, gives to Kiesling. Kiesling with Garrick in his jersey. One dribble, baseline to Hadley. Hadley dribbles to the wing. Now top of the key, switches directions, comes back to the baseline. Back to Kiesling, top of the key. Right wing to Watterson, down the corner to Miller. Miller drives the baseline, shot over Kennedy's no good, gets his own rebound, and before the shot's put back, Miller is fouled by, I believe, Kennedy, and that could be foul number 2 on Luke if it is indeed on him.
Oh, yeah. Wow, that's a tough call on Luke. Once again, Zebra's getting burnt on the baseline, and he's coming over to help. And then the shot goes up, and the Zebras kind of watch the ball. A bad habit there, and then the Cass pick guys just keep going after the ball. And then,
right,
as oftentimes you see, an offensive rebound usually leads to a defensive foul.
Cy Holland in the game for Rochester. He replaces Garrick in the Zebra lineup. Alders down low, has his ball tipped away and stolen by Korn. Now gives to Cy Holland. Holland quickly up the floor to Screeton. Now to Kennedy. Kennedy against Aldridge. Looking back door, turnaround 10-footer in the lane is no good. Miller with a rebound. And Jordan Miller gives off to Hadley, and Cass comes the other way, up by one with under 2 minutes to play in the opening quarter. Bixler, his teardrop shot in the lane is no good. Odell loses it out of bounds, and it's going to stay with Lewis Cass, baseline right.
Tale of two teams here scoring-wise. We said Cass has had four different players score 2 points each for their eight. Odell has all seven for Rochester. Okay.
Garrick back in the game, and Luke Kennedy will sit with two personal fouls. Bixler looks to get it in, does so over the defense to Miller behind the arc on the right side, right in front of Coach Reinholdt. Now to Aldridge. Aldridge goes to the rack hard. He's fouled on the shot. He'll go to the line for two.
Like a veteran team probably would. With Luke Kennedy out, Rochester only gets smaller and
yeah.
Probably try to pound it inside even more. Aldridge had a good battle with Kennedy, but now he's got a mismatch inside and probably see Cass try to pound it in even more.
Seth Korn, Rochester's tallest on the floor, 6'2", and Miller and Aldridge 6'4 and 6'3 respectively. So Aldridge has two free throws. First left-handed free throw on the way is no good. Off the side of the rim, he'll have one more. Yeah, if Miller and Aldridge used to playing against the big guys, they ought to make hay here with Kennedy on the bench. Aldridge with one more. Second on the way is short. Miller with a rebound. The putback over Odell is short. The putback again is no good. Ball being tipped around, and Screen comes out of there with it. Hadley knocks it away. Screen picks it up. Now gives it to Garrick. Really? Three-point blank shot by Miller. Couldn't get one of them to go. Odell on the baseline. Pull-up jumper on the way is no good. Too long, and Aldridge with the rebound. Now to Hadley. We've got a scrum down court, down floor. And Hadley hits Streeton in the head with a shoe.
I think that's going to be Carter's second. Rochester's sixth. So Cass is shooting free throws the rest of the way, and there's a minute 28 left in the first.
Cass up 8-7. Lewis Cass goes back to the bench, and they'll bring in Owen Oman, and Watterson will go to the locker room.
That's where you're at. You know, as a coach, it's a fine line between aggressiveness and out of control. You want your guys to come out and compete and play hard and be aggressive, but you also have to know your foul situation. And, you know, unfortunately, Cass is shooting free throws the rest of the way.
Lewis Cass up 8-7 with a minute 20 to play in the first quarter as Miller holds in the corner behind the arc, down low to Aldridge, and Aldridge is fouled on the entry pass by Seth Korn. So back to the line will be Ryan Aldridge for one of the bonus with a 1:14 to play in the first quarter.
And another Zebra with two fouls. Kennedy's on the bench with two. That's Korn's second. Carter Streeton has two as well.
So how soon, Tony, do you think that with the foul situation the Zebras have before they fall back into that 2-3 zone?
Boy, I don't know. Their defense isn't bad. It's tough. You know, there's some bodies flying around inside, and then it seems like in the post defense, they're not letting them play post defense, but they're letting them battle for loose balls
right.
And do those kinds of things. That's tough to adjust to as a player.
Aldridge misses the front end of the 1-1, and Rochester has it out going to our left. Cy Holland gives Odell behind the arc. Again, Odell has all 7 points for Rochester, and he is fouled on the shot, and it goes. Odell took that shot from the left elbow to make that the right elbow. And in the act of shooting, he was fouled. Got it to go. He'll have one free throw. Looking to put his Zebras up by two.
A little LeBron continuation, I think, Frank.
Well, I was thinking that as well, but
we're not going to turn it down. And Odell has all 9 Zebra points thus far.
John's free throw on the way. Short and draws nothing but backboard. And Lewis Cass will have it. 58.2 to play in the first quarter. Rochester back up 9-8. And the Kings with the basketballs. Hadley will run the point for the Lewis Cass Kings. He'll walk it through the center circle for the Rochester Zebras. And Rochester now in a 2-3 zone. Aldridge turnaround jumper from the free throw line. No good. And Miller with a rebound. Miller's put back over the defense is no good. His follow-up put back is no good. And we're going to have a foul on Jordan Miller for over the back with 45.7 to play in the first quarter.
That's the thing. The zone helps you play interior defense and keep the ball out in the possession. But once the shot goes up, the zone is very tough. Especially with the big guys, you've got to know who you're blocking out. You've got to get bodies on the big guys, or you'll end up still getting yourself in foul trouble.
Miller still had two opportunities on that possession.
Right, he's about 0-5 from inside 2 feet in the last minute or so.
35 seconds to play, first quarter. Rochester up 9-8. Alec Holland gives the corner behind the arc on the right wing. Got a Cy Holland top of the key. outside. A couple of dribbles against Bixler in the man-to-man defense. Gives to Garrick. Alec Garrick strong to the basket. Throws up a shot. He's fouled on the shot. He'll go to the line for two.
Now, there's a situation where Rochester's size disadvantage on defense helps them because they're going small. Aldrich has to come out and guard Garrick. So you've got a big post guy on a guard. They spread the floor. Alec took him and drew the foul.
Alec Garrick will go to the line to shoot. Two free throws. First on the way is good.
Well, this is a good break for the Zebras. They called it on Miller, which will be his second. I thought that was on Aldridge, which would only be his first, but that's going to be Miller's second. So you're taking out one of the big guys. Zebras get a little break with Kennedy on the bench in foul trouble. One of the big guys from Cass comes out, so it's a little bit more even for the Zebras.
Victor DeJesus makes his first appearance into the basketball game as Rochester up by two. Garrick's one more free throw, no good. And Lewis Cass with the rebound. Hadley, crossover dribble right side. Behind his back dribble works to the right corner to Bixler. Bixler, a couple of dribbles with 14 seconds. Now outside to Omen. His three on the way, and the wing is good. And Cass back up 11-10 with 6 seconds to play. Alec Holland in the backcourt loses the handle with three. Pushes the ball ahead to Bixler. Sails over Cass. His jumper on the way at the buzzer is no good. After one, Lewis Cass leading 11-10. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
And here's True Value Hardware Rental and Paint Store, 1619 Main Street in Rochester, reminds you they have all the paint and paint supplies to make your home glow this holiday season. Choose Easy Care Interior Paint for one coat coverage. See Ender's line of Melissa and Doug toys. They have the largest selection in the area, and these beautiful toys are child safe and child friendly. For holiday gift giving, check out Ender's line of housewares. They've added to their selections to make your shopping easier. And from lighted trees to a full line of holiday decor, including wrapping paper, light sets, garland, serge strips, gifts, bags, and tags, well, Enyart's has you covered. Enyart's True Value. Start right. Start here.
Terrorist attacks, war, floods, and tornadoes. Our lives have always had to confront major catastrophic events. Christians accept the fact that these events happen and talk about them with Jesus Christ. We also share the positive things that happen when one of the advantages of knowing Jesus as your personal Savior. Find out more about this by attending one of our services at Grace United Methodist Church on Saturday at 5:30 p.m. and Sunday at 9:30 a.m. Our church is located at the corner of 7th and Jefferson Streets in Rochester.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
Second quarter of action here at Rochester High School. The Kings leading 11-10. And Rochester will start the second period with the basketball. Alec and Cy Holland on the floor. Garrick, Odell, and Korn.
Looks like Cass is in the 2-3 zone for the first time tonight.
Miller on the bench for Lewis Cass with two fouls. And speaking of two fouls, Rochester has several of them. Odell for three from the right corner. Foul on the shot. No call. He gets it to go. Rochester back up 11-13. I believe John Odell has 12 of the 13 points.
That's correct.
Kiesling back into the game for Lewis Cass to Bixler. Back to Kiesling over the defense. In the corner now to Omen. To Omen. And I believe Aldridge is fouled on the entry pass. Is that going to be on Korn?
I think it's on Cyrus.
Yeah, that's good.
The Zebras in a 1-3-1 half-court trap. Cyrus Holland was playing the back of that. And Cass got it to the wing like they've been doing, the wing and then the post rolling down. And Cyrus helped out and reached a little bit too much.
Aldridge has a free throw. He's short again. DeJesus with the rebound. Down low to Omen. His putback is no good. And Garrick with the rebound. I don't think Aldridge has hit a free throw yet. He's had about four or five opportunities.
Right.
Odell's pull-up 15-footer is good. 15-11. Rochester up by four with 7:10 to play in the first half.
Back in the 1-3-1 trap.
DeJesus down low, gives to a cutting Omen, his shot partially blocked. Aldridge with the rebound, follow-up shot is good, and it's 15-13. Quickly up the court are the Zebras. Alec Holland to Odell, who gives ahead to his Korn. Seth Korn goes to the basket, pull-up jumper over DeJesus is good, and it's 17-13. Rochester by four with 6:45 to play in the first half.
Zebras have to tighten up their rotations on this 1-3-1. Actually, they switch back to man.
Kiesling, top of the key, works the right wing, picks up a dribble, gives to Aldridge the volleyball at the free throw line to head to Jesus, stolen by Holland. Alec Holland now brings it up the floor for Rochester, pushes ahead to Odell, long three for the Zebras, right wing is good again. Timeout, Lewis Cass. You're listening to Zebra Basketball. Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Jennings Insurance, your professional Pekin insurance agency located in Argus and Rochester, believes in the game of life and pays to make sure you're safely covered with insurance. They can help you cover all the bases, whether it's auto, homeowners, life, business, health, or an annuity. At Jennings Insurance, they'll help you compare rates and prices. That's Jennings Insurance and Pekin teaming up to help you plan ahead for protection against those unexpected plays in the game of life.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
6:23 to play in the first half. Rochester up 20-13, and it's been John O'Dell here in the first half.
Yeah, John O'Dell has 17 of the Zebras' 20 points. He's already hit three threes and just doing a great job of variety of defenses. You know, Cass might probably going to rethink that 2-3 they've been in. They may go back to face guard and try something else.
I'm not even sure if that was a good shot. I think he was drifting towards the sideline when he hit that three.
Call that a heat check. How hot am I?
I'd say he's fairly hot.
Yeah.
Rochester up by 7 with 6:23 to play. Coach Kitchell not happy with the defense there put on by his king. Left Odell wide open. Of course, he was about 6 feet behind the arc, so you can't hardly fault the kids for letting him shoot that. I think I would, too.
Right. Here's back in the 2-2-1.
Kiesling, no-look pass down low to Watterson. His shot no good. Aldridge with the rebound. The putback is good. Another second-chance opportunity for the Lewis Cass Kings. This time, the Kings and Aldridge able to get it to go.
Just got to find Aldridge on those first shot opportunities.
Five-point lead for Rochester. Now Bixler steals it for Cass. Lewis Cass going to our right. Crossover dribble. Bixler's foul on the shot. He'll go to the line for two.
That's Carter Screeton's third foul.
5:51 to play in the first half. Rochester up 20-15. And Ryan Bixler will go to the line to shoot two. Ryan Bixler is a 5'10 freshman for the Kings. And Luke Kennedy, speaking of three fouls, well,
don't say that.
He has two. He'll come back in after this free throw by Bixler. It's too hard off the back of the iron. He'll have one more. So Kennedy back in, and Streeton will sit with three personals. Cody Stasiak, I'm David Musselman.
I think what you're trying to do with Luke is, I don't know that you're expecting him to finish the last 5:51 of the half, but try to get a couple minutes here, steal a couple minutes, maybe get him the ball on the offensive end, make him, you know, play, let him play offense as much as possible, and then maybe sit him in the last couple without getting that third.
Miller is on the bench for Lewis Cass, so both Aldridge and Kennedy, the tallest guys on the floor. Jacob Houdeshell in the game for the first time for the Rochester Zebras. The Kings make one of two on that trip at the free throw line to cut the lead to four with 5:35 to play in the first half. Garrick for three, left baseline is no mark, no good. Kennedy with a rebound. Luke backs his way in. Turnaround jumper of the way is no good, but a foul coming on Cass, and Kennedy will go to the line to shoot two.
That's going
to
be on Watterson. That's his first. Good job with Luke. It's that dangerous long rebound on the backside, and you've got a Cass guy in front of you, but he did a good job. He didn't make contact. He jumped backwards away from the kid so as not to draw that over the back foul.
Kennedy with a free, two free throws. Luke ready. Fires a first right-handed free throw. It rolls around the rim and falls off. He'll have one more. Four-point lead for the Z's with 5.5 to play in the first half. Kennedy with one more for the Zebras.
This is only Luke's eighth free throw attempt of the season. Mid-ninth. He's 4-for-7 coming into this game.
Kennedy's second one good this time. 21-16 Rochester. And Lewis Cass with the basketball coming to our right. 2-1-2 half-court trap. Kiesling crosses the timeline around the defense. Almost loses the handle. Picks up the dribble. Now works right corner to Watterson. Jump pass down low to Aldridge. Aldridge backs away in against Kennedy. Against the triple team, his shot goes.
It's a veteran post player that knows Kennedy can't do much, and if he just stays with it, he'll probably get at least a shot off, if not a foul.
21-18. Odell for three in the wing. That's off the back there. No good. And Kiesling skies to the board and grabs it and clear himself. Kingsley behind his back dribble across the timeline right against Garrick. Crossover dribble works left side. Gets a pick from Aldridge. Kicks it outside to Ullman. His three on the way is off the mark. No good. Watterson the rebound. His putback over Odell is no good. And Garrick clears the board. 21-18 Rochester. 4:40 to play in the first half. Houdeshell now to Garrick. Alec Garrick with the basketball behind the arc on the wing. Now to Houdeshell, top of the key of the volleyball line. Now to Alec Garrick, Alec Holland for three. It's no good. Watterson to the rebound. And now to Kiesling. Three-point lead for the Zebras. 4:20 to play in the first half. Bixler cutting to the lane. Takes a shot. It's good and a foul. And Odell's going to pick up the foul.
John is one of the few Zebras not in foul trouble. That's only his first, but it is the Zebras' 10th, so that's an and-one situation. He's only going to get one here, but Cass will shoot two for the rest of the half on every foul.
Kennedy comes out, so like Tony said, he got some time without a foul, and Seth Corner comes back into the game.
Yeah, needed to give Seth a blow, but you can't really have both of those two off the floor at the same time.
Yeah. So Bixler at the line to shoot one to try to complete the three-point play and tie this game at 21. He does so. 4:18 to play in the first half as Hadley comes back into the game for the Kings, and Bixler will sit down. Tony Stasiak, I'm David Musselman. We're at Rochester High School.
All the scoring done this quarter by Cass is done by Aldridge and Bixler. Aldridge has 6, Bixler has 4.
Well, Aldridge is throwing his weight around as the pass is tipped out of bounds by Holman. It'll stay with the Zebras here in front of the scorer's table.
Cass giving their own look at a little three-quarters court trap pressure.
That lackadaisical pass will jump up and bite the Zebras in the butt every time if they don't watch it.
Always got to go get your pass.
4 minutes to play, first half. We're tied at 21 coming up at halftime. First half stats. Also, the Rochester Zebra wrestlers were in action today at Wawa City. They went 3-2, and we'll have some results from that contest. Alec Garrick for 3, left wing, good! And Rochester up by 3 at the 2. I beg your pardon, his foot was on the line. And Rochester up by 2 at 23-21. What does Scott Mills used to call that area? Right side of Watterson.
Dead zone.
Yeah, that's right. Kiesling, left side of Hadley. Hadley now backs it out and will reset for the Lewis Cass Kings against Houdeshell. Works left side. He'll fire up his own 3 from the wing. No good. And the rebound to Ullman. Ullman then, jumper from the free throw line is no good. And Odell skies to the board. John will run to our left. Up by 2. Odell spins. Jumper. Good. 25-21. Back to a 4-point lead for the Zebras.
It's like when you're playing those video games, like those NBA 2K13s, and you got Kobe, and you just make him do all this crazy stuff. That's kind of what John's doing out there. It's his night.
Kiesling for 3 is good, and that cuts the lead to 1. Yeah, you're right. And Owen knocks the pass out of bounds. You know, Coach Reinhold told me in the pregame that one thing they cannot do is they cannot let Kiesling get hot. And if so, it's going to be a long night for Rochester.
Yeah, that's the first breakdown. They've played him pretty tight, not face guarding him, but they've always known where he's been regards to the defense. That time got caught a little bit, gave him a few too many steps open, and he took advantage, knocked down a 3.
Ty Holland back in the game, and John Odell sits down with a ton of points. 25-24 Rochester, just under 3 minutes to play in the first half.
Cast in a 2-2-1 three-quarters court. Zebras, obviously a lot of points sitting on the bench with Odell, have to be smart with this possession.
Holland on the wing. Outside to Alec Holland. On the baseline now to Cy. Cy holds left side. Now inside the arc, kicks out to Eric. Alec Garrick. Now to Houdeshell. Jacob Houdeshell gives baseline to Seth Corner with 2.5 minutes to play in the first half. Rochester by 1. Houdeshell inside to Corn. Loses the handle. Picked up by Kiesling. Kiesling will go coast to coast. Left hand layup is no good. And Garrick with the rebound. Gives to Alec Holland. Rochester runs to our left. Holland right side of the floor. Goes to basket. And the ball is tipped out of bounds by Aldridge. And Rochester going to keep possession baseline right with 2:19 to play in the first half.
That was a tremendous break by the Zebras for Garrick to get that rebound and kick that thing out. And it doesn't take Alec Holland very long to get down the floor.
Unfortunately for Alec, the tallest guy on the floor was back waiting for him in Aldridge.
Not fair. You worked that hard to get a layup, and the kid just has to stand there to block your shot.
Cy Holland at the elbow, left extended, gives to Korn behind the arc in the left corner. Seth Korn drives the baseline. Pull-up jumper over Aldridge is good. Nice-looking athletic move by Seth Korn, and Rochester back up by 3 with 2 minutes to play in the first half.
I like that because instead of taking the jumper, he put the ball in the deck and went to the rack.
Bixler loses the basketball and saves from going out of bounds right into the hands of Garrick, and he pushes ahead to Houdeshell. Jacob Houdeshell hesitates. Now accelerates around Aldridge, cut off on the baseline, and we're going to have a travel on Rochester.
You know, one thing I have noticed is Aldridge is a very disciplined post player, very impressed with his offensive game, but defensively, he does not go for the shot fakes. He stays on his feet at all times. Now, granted, he doesn't have to necessarily on some of those guys, but even against the bigger guys, he's not trying to jump to block a shot. You can see how he stays out of foul trouble. Very good player.
27-24 Rochester, a minute 40 to play in the first half, and the Kings of the basketball going to our right. Watterson behind the arc on the right side. Gives to Bixler at the elbow right. Bixler with the basketball. One dribble cut off by the defense out of Kiesling. Kiesling's 18-footer right side is no good, but a foul coming on the Zebras, and I believe Kiesling will go to the line to shoot two. Boy, that's a tough foul to give with 17 feet away from the basket.
You know, you're trying to work hard and get through the screen. But in that case, Garrick just a little too much mustard on that get through and end up taking out the screener. So the foul is called on Garrick.
Austin Kiesling.
So I think, well, now that you say that, I'm thinking that why is Garrick or Kiesling shooting? Because he was. And if the foul was going through the screen, wouldn't the screener be the shooter? And that's exactly what Coach Reinhold just said.
Yep. That's Garrick was chasing the screener.
So Austin Kiesling will be at the line to shoot two.
Shooting two.
You're right. Kiesling had the shot. I did not see contact on the shot. I saw contact taking out the screener. Kiesling was not the screener.
Free throw is good by the junior Austin Kiesling. He'll have one more. 27-25, Rochester, a minute 28 to play in the first half. Kiesling with one more for his Kings. Right-handed free throw on the way is good again.
That's perfect.
Full court press
format.
Full court press now by the Kings. 2-2-1.
Yep, Zebras got to try to get the 2-1-2 to go against it, get that middle open.
Seth Korn, layup, no good. Aldridge with the rebound. Gives ahead to Kiesling. Rochester up by one with a minute 10 to play in the first half. Kiesling, bounce pass left wing to Bixler. Back to Kiesling near the timeline. We're down to 65 seconds to play first half. Rochester by one, 27-26. Bounce pass right side to Watterson. Stands behind the arc. Gives to Bixler. Cuts through the lane. Loses his footing, but gives the ball to Aldridge before he falls. Aldridge puts it off the glass and good. And the Kings back up by one. 28-27.
10 points for Aldridge now.
2-2-1. Press again by the Kings. Over and back. Good call, Taze. Seth Korn gave it up too early as Cy Holland was not across the timeline before he touched the basketball.
Seen that a few times this year. Saw it in the JV game earlier. Yep. You've got to establish that position on the other side of the line before you can catch that pass.
So the Kings with 42 seconds to play in the first half and a 28-27 lead with a basketball. Their half-court trap. Nope. Kiesling for three. Look out. In and out. No good. Ball tipped around. Odell comes out of there with it. Now to Hadashell. Gives ahead to Garrick with 27 seconds. Garrick. Finger off the glass is no good, but he's fouled on the shot by Bixler. He'll go to the line to shoot two.
Nice move. Nice move by Garrick. Looked like he was going to go straight in, and they were ready to block his shot. But, the best example I can use is that Manu Ginobili for the Spurs. He kind of sidestepped and created some angles. Instead of stepping straight, he kind of stepped to the side and created an angle to get a shot off, and he'll shoot two.
Garrick at the line. First one, right into free throw is good, and we're tied at 28.
Garrick was 1-for-2 so far from the line before that one. That's his fourth point of the night.
25.7 to play first half. We're tied at 28, and Garrick with one more from the charity stripe for the Rochester Zebras. Second one on the way is good again. Rochester back up by one at 29-28, and Hadley and the Kings will bring it up the floor. Out of Kiesling, back to Hadley, near side. Hadley, bounce pass left side to Kiesling. On the baseline to Bixler, gives it back to Kiesling behind the arc, left side. He's in lane, jump stop, jumper. He rises up to shoot, no good. Hadley, Aldridge with the rebound, his shot put back, it's good, and a foul.
Defensive breakdown, it's tough to lose the biggest guy on the floor, but they've just done that the last couple of possessions. Nobody blocking out the big guy.
Another offensive board for not only the Kings, but another offensive chance for Aldridge, and he'll go to line to shoot one free throw, which is fortunate for Rochester. If you're going to foul anybody, you foul him because he is hasn't hit anything from the line tonight.
He's got 10 points this quarter, 12 for the game, but he's 0-for-3 from the line.
Aldridge ready, left-handed free throw on the way. Short, no good. Corner of the board. Now to Odell with seven. John Odell spins around, crosses the timeline with four. John Odell is tied up with Hadley, and the Kings are going to get it back with 3.6 to play in the first half, up by one. Alec Holland back into the game, and Hadashell to sit.
A jump ball is simultaneous possession. I would think it would take you probably longer than a half a second to get possession.
You would think. That's just exactly right.
Just saying.
Watterson to inbounds. Does so to Bixler with three. Bixler to Keys to Hadley. His prayer at the buzzer is no good.
And also in a girls' game at half, Frontier wins in double overtime against Cass and don't have that final score. Guys' game we have, Manchester's playing Garin Catholic. Garin Catholic's up 30-18 at half in that game.
Is that the girls' game?
Yes.
Culver?
Yes. Or from this afternoon, Culver Community Girls defeated Jimtown 51-43. Culver is 3-0 in the Northern States Conference. Winnemac had an easy victory in the Midwest Conference 73-44 over North White.
As we start the third quarter, the Zebras will have the basketball. Garrick, Alec, Holland, Odell, Korn, and Kennedy on the floor for Rochester, the original five. And Lewis Castoni starts in a 2-3 zone.
2-3 zone, not face guarding Odell. Odell's running the baseline. They're just kind of keeping tabs of him. He's running across the baseline.
So Watterson leaves the game immediately, goes to the locker room, and now he comes out in a face mask, and I would have to believe, I don't know this for sure, but maybe a nose issue, a broken nose issue.
Yeah, I noticed when he came back in the first half, he did have some gauze in his nostril.
Kennedy shot no good. His follow-up shot no good. He gets it back. He puts it back up and good off of 1 foot.
Not exactly to the way you draw up that shot, but he got it to go down. Good work.
Rochester.
Good work by Garrick to keep it alive.
Yeah. Rochester back up by one at 31-30 early on here in this second half. Tony Stasiak, I'm David Musselman. Kiesling turnaround jumper. The paint is good. That's a good-looking shot by Kiesling.
A little bit different look by Calf. They didn't have him bring the ball up the floor. They ran him off some screens for an open look.
No. Korn gives to Garrick. And we're going to have a foul on the play. And I believe Luke Kennedy just picked up foul number three. That was certainly away from the ball.
Wow. This, man, the ability of Luke Kennedy to keep it together after what some of the calls he's had this year has just been so tough. Now, hopefully, it's an interesting decision. You're down one, 7 minutes to go. You've got him on Aldrich, the big man underneath. You've got to assume Cass will go right at him.
You know, we're a minute into the second half, and Kennedy and Aldrich already mixing it up down low.
It's a good battle. Unfortunately, only one of them has been able to stay on the floor for extended periods.
Hadley around the pick. His shot partially blocked. Odell picks up the ball and pushes ahead to Alec Holland. Rochester down by one. Holland right side of the floor. Pulls up 15 feet away. Gives to Odell about 10 feet away from the three-point line. I figured he's going to chuck that thing. To Korn, back to Odell. No-look pass in the corner to Garrick. 32-31, Lewis Cass with 6:20 to play in the third quarter.
You know, some of this by looking at this offensive philosophy by the Zebras, maybe he's actually slowing this game down a little bit. Let's, if they're going to play zone, spread it out a little bit. Make them chase you.
Garrick's jumper is no good. Aldridge clears the board and gives to Hadley. Lewis Cass running to our left, up by one, and Hadley runs the point for the Kings. Works against Rochester's man-to-man defense. Now high on the right side to Watterson. Just pass to Kiesling, top of the key at the volleyball line. Kiesling taking some time, like you said, Stazer, kind of slowing down a little bit and making the Zebras work here defensively. Kiesling around the defense and is fouled before the shot. Well, that first step for Austin Kiesling is explosive, and he got around Garrick in no time at all.
Yeah, I think he's a little quicker than Garrick anyways, and as he's got his momentum coming to the ball, and Alec is already chasing him, he just extended his distance.
Aldridge gives to Watterson, to Miller, to Aldridge in the lane. Aldridge stops, pops, good. Nice hard move to the basket by Aldridge, and it's 34-31 Lewis Cass.
Got to be a nice feeling when you can have a layup and slap the backboard on your way up.
Can slap the bottom of the backboard outside to Odell. Jump pass, top of Keita Korn, loses it through his hands. Hadley picks it up. Hadley will go in for the right-handed layup. It's no good. Aldridge the baller. His shot no good, and now we're going to have a foul on the putback. Aldridge looked to follow up with a rebound dunk all in one time. It hung on the rim and got off the rim just in time for Kiesling to put the shot up, or that would have been a goaltending. How does he not get a technical call on that?
You know, I guess say that he's as a safety purpose rather than come down on somebody, you can use the rim. But that's an interesting call there.
Kiesling hits the free throw. He'll have one more.
Perfect from the line. 3-for-3 so far today for Mr. Kiesling.
Kings up by four. One more coming for the junior with 5:15 to play in the first half. Second on the way is good again. As it kind of hung on the front of the rim and goes through. Full court press by the Kings. Garrick loses a handle.
Two,
now we're going to have a travel on Alec Garrick as Kiesling thought he committed a foul. And I believe all the Rochester fans did too. 5:11 to play in the third quarter. Lewis Cass by five at 36-31. The Kings have it baseline left. Hadley gets the inbound pass from Kiesling, who backs it out near the volleyball line on the wing. Kiesling against Garrett, makes that Alec Holland. Hadley goes to the basket. His shot no good. Aldridge to put back no good. And Luke Kennedy just picked up foul number two. I'm sorry, foul number four.
Yep.
And Aldridge will go to the line to shoot two.
That's another situation. Missed blockout opportunity. Gives the big man a rebound and gets fouled on the putback.
Ryan Aldridge. Carter Screen will come back in after this first free throw by Aldridge, who misses nothing and almost missed net as well. It was so bad.
Here's an interesting concept. Taylor Medina's coming in the game for Luke Kanaday. Taylor Medina has not played. He has five fouls. The way this kid has shot free throws, every time he gets the ball inside, rather than let him score, I think I might foul him and make him earn it rather than giving up the easy one.
I agree with that. I don't think that Coach Reinhold spent that much time with Taylor Medina to let him know that. But we'll see. As Aldridge misses both free throws, it's still a five-point lead for the Kings. Derek to Streeton, left side to Korn. Korn out to Medina. Taylor skip pass to Streeton and has it taken away. Oh, we're going to have a foul on the reach in by Watterson. Yikes.
Well, when you look up and the home team has four fouls and the guests have none, I don't think there's ever a such thing as a makeup call or get even.
No.
The referees will look at the scoreboard and see fouls, but we'll take it.
Odell gets it into Korn in the backcourt. Steph holds out a screen who runs the point right in front of the Rochester bench. 4.5 to play in the third quarter. Rochester down by 5 at 36-31. Derek high on the left side for the Zebras. Looking for a flashing Medina, can't get it to him. Now to Screen at the volleyball, at the free throw line. Now to Garrick, a three on the way, draws nothing but air. Watterson picks up the loose ball rebound and gives the head to Kiesling. Kiesling accelerates to Miller. Left-handed layup is good. And now Rochester will use a 60-second timeout. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Don't miss the opportunity to share the fantastic programming available this holiday season exclusively on RFD-TV, culminating with the broadcast of the 2013 Tournament of Roses Parade. This free preview is an opportunity to allow all expanded basic Rochester Telephone Company cable customers to sample the 100% family-friendly programming on RFD-TV. Beginning December 17th through January 2nd, you will find RFD-TV on RTC Channel 80. Merry Christmas and Happy New Year from all of us at Rochester Telephone. And give us a like on Facebook. We'd love to have you as our friend.
If you're stuck with high monthly car payments and think it's the best you can do, think again. By refinancing your car loan with State Farm Bank, you may save on your monthly payments and have more money to spend on other things. Call State Farm agent Jeff Klinkhammer at 223-3017 for more information. Jeff will help you see how much you could save by refinancing with State Farm Bank. That's Jeff Klinkhammer at 223-3017. State Farm Bank, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
4:11 to play in the third quarter. Rochester trailing 38-31, and the Zebras break the full court press. John Odell, three right baseline is short. Garrett grabs the board, but we're going to have a foul from the official across the court, and it's going to be a foul against Garrick for over the back, I'm guessing.
The guy farthest away makes the call. Two guys within 5 feet do not make the call. I can tell you as a coach,
drives you crazy.
Frustrating.
Yeah. Cass has it back under four to play in the third, up by 7. Hadley high on the right wing, Kiesling top of the key. Kiesling around the defense, gives it outside to Hadley, fakes the three, drives inside the paint, now backs the back out and takes some time off the clock for the Kings against the Rochester's man-to-man defense. Hadley now to Kiesling near the timeline.
This is a danger zone a little bit for the Zebras. Cass is up 38-31. You're down 7. You've got your big man on the bench with 4 fouls. Cass is going to be a little bit patient. The Zebras can't get rattled. You're still within 7. It's only the third quarter, but you got to play good defense without fouling.
They've already ran off about 30 seconds here after the foul on Garrick. Kiesling around the defense and the baseline to Miller. Runs a baseline shot over Odell is good. It's a 9-point lead now for Lewis Cass as they begin to pull away here from the Rochester Zebras. Are 3:05 to play in the third quarter. Garrick gets it across to Medina. Taylor Medina pull up 15-footers. Good as it rattles home.
Definitely need that. Come off the bench looking to score. That's good. Medina had a good JV game.
Build
on that now.
And he played all 7 quarters of the JV game. Yeah, that's right. The JV game went to triple overtime as Cass won 47-45. Hadley backs it out with 2:40 to play in the third. Now Kiesling has it between the rings. Works around Garrick. And Kiesling just got a shoulder in the grill as I believe Garrick pushed him into him. And it's going to be out of bounds to the Lewis Cass Kings. But like we mentioned in the first quarter, Lewis Cass will be shooting here for the rest of the basketball game.
Yeah, and once again, another Zebra who can't stay out of foul trouble this year. Al Garrick picks up his fourth, more of a frustration foul there.
2:35 to play in the third quarter. Hadley dribbles around in the backcourt, now brings it out near the timeline. It works against Streeton. 2:25 to play in the third. Rochester down by 7 at 40-33. Kiesling to Hadley. And it looks like, Tony, that you just said it. They're just looking to take some time off the clock. Hadley gives to a cutting Aldridge, who loses the basketball out of bounds.
Nice job.
Nice game plan. And it was there. Aldridge just lost it.
Yeah, it'd be interesting if you could talk to the coach. Things were going pretty well for him. He got a 7-point lead. Now you want to slow it down. What are you looking for? Maybe to try to spread him out and then, like you say, run some time and then attack and hope that the big guys can slide behind the defense.
Four-court press by the Kings. Streeton doesn't cross the timeline. Now does. Ty Holland to Medina to Streeton to Odell. His layup is no good. And Miller the board quickly to Hadley. Kings run with a 7-point lead with a minute 50 to play in the third. And now Hadley will knock it back, bring it back out and run some more time for the Kings. He gives to Kiesling, who's in the center circle. 1:40 to play in the third. Crossover dribble works left side. Backside Holland to the three-point line. Now backs out near the timeline with a minute 30 to play in the third quarter. Kings up 40-33. Hadley behind the arc to Kiesling. Kiesling around the defense. Stops. Pops. Nope. Rebound tipped around. Kiesling has it. He'll put it back up over Medina. His shot's good and a foul.
That's going to be Kiesling has 11th point. Foul's going to be on Odell. That's Odell's second and the Zebra's seventh of this quarter.
A minute 21 to play in the third quarter. Kiesling has an opportunity to stretch this lead to double digits, and he does so with that freebie. 43-33, Lewis Cass, Rochester basketball. Cass in the zone. The zone press. Korn gets it ahead to Odell. John Odell runs a baseline. His jumper over Miller's partially blocked. He gets it back. He's fouled before the shot. It'll be out of bounds to Rochester underneath their own basket.
Maybe Odell's shooting too close. You know, the first half, all those points came from, you know, everything outside 15 feet. The
right.
Last couple ones have been point-blank shots. Maybe he needs to step back farther.
I can pass it out to Rex if you'd like. Yeah. Cy Holland. Baseline left, looks to get it in. Gets it into Medina. Medina's shot, good, and a foul. Nice job by Taylor Medina, posted up Watterson. And Cy Holland finally got in the ball, and easy picking from there.
That's Watterson's third foul and Cass's third foul of the quarter. Medina going to go to the line looking for his fifth point.
A minute six to play. And the third quarter, of course, this is Taylor's only quarter of the night for the Rochester Zebras. Free throw on the way is good. 43-36. Bixler coming back in the game and Watterson to sit.
I think what they're trying to do is, I think Cass has finally decided, hey, you know, we tried some offense. Zebra's been pretty good. Let's just spread him out. Kiesling has 7 points himself this quarter. So let's spread him out, let him attack, and if the posts help up, the big guys are open. If not, Kiesling can get to the line or get a shot off.
Under a minute to play in the third quarter, 43-36 for Rochester. I'm sorry, Lewis Cass. And Cy Holland just picks up a foul about 25 feet away from the basket. And that's going to send the freshman Bixler to the line for one of the bonus.
And Cyrus is... just lost it. Cyrus's second foul. And Zebra's eighth.
Ryan Bixler, the 5'10 freshman at the line for one of the bonus for his Kings. Leading by 7. Free throw is no good. And Corn grabs the board. And gives to Streeton. Rochester running to our right. 50 seconds to play in the third. Streeton holds at the top of the key against the 2-3 zone of the Lewis Cass Kings. We're down to 40 seconds to play in the third. Now Cy Holland with the basketball. Cy, one dribble to Streeton left side. Fakes the shot. Gives the corner to the baseline. Seth a couple of dribbles against the double team. Now gives back to Streeton with 30. Cy Holland holds now top of the key with 27. Left side to Streeton. He'll fire a three from the wing. No good. And it hits the backboard support.
You know, this extended pressure, token pressure, you're not getting the turnovers from Cass. And sometimes pressure's not about turnovers, but they definitely have gotten Rochester out of the offensive rhythm. They've gotten them uncomfortable, and the Zebras have gone cold. Only 7 points this quarter.
Yeah. 7-point lead for the Kings with 14 seconds to play in the third quarter. Lewis Cass with the basketball. Kiesling gives it, cutting Aldridge. His shot is good with 9. 9-point lead for Lewis Cass with 7. Street has it with 5. Ahead to Odell with 3. Odell loses the basketball from behind. Gives to Hadley. Hadley half-quarter to buzzer. Good! Lewis Cass leads by 12 after 3. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Why purchase a new or pre-owned vehicle from Mike Anderson? This is John Adair, General Manager, and after visiting with a satisfied customer, this is what they told me. I never felt pressured. I appreciated the salesperson's honest approach. He explained why we might want to consider a different vehicle than the one we originally thought I wanted. I was amazed at how easy it was to get financed, and my salesperson took the time to explain all the features of my car before I even drove off the lot. So the fact is, at Mike Anderson Chrysler Dodge Jeep and Ram Truck, we want every one of our customers to say, I love my car, after the sale. We mean it when we say, now you have a friend in the car business.
Rochester High School, the Kings now up by 12, the biggest lead of the night for either squad. And that 12-point spread comes at the hands of Hadley, who buried a half-quarter. Actually, he's on the Rochester side of half-court. And to put the Kings up by 12.
18 points that quarter for Cass. Only 7 for the Zebras. John Odell leads the Zebras with 19. The only problem with that is all 19 came in the first half. He's scoreless in the third quarter. In the meantime, Kiesling has 12 and Aldridge has 16 for Cass. And Kiesling's going to go to the line with Kings up 48-36. Going to go and look to get his 13th point of the night.
Kiesling has been perfect from the line except for that free throw is no good. And Korn with the basketball to Hadashell back to Seth Korn. Tony Stasiak, I'm David Musselman. Fourth and final quarter here at Rochester High School. The Zebras trailing by 12 at 48-36. Cy Holland with it. Now to Hadashell on the left side. Hadashell, one dribble. Picks it up top of the key against Kiesling. Now high on the left side. It was Odell to Holland on the baseline. Alec Holland shot's partially blocked. He picks it up off the side of the backboard and then travels. I thought that went behind the backboard.
Yeah, and just don't have the best angle here, but I think he just got a little frustrated. You know, the big guy's waiting on him. He's already had a shot blocked by him once, and
yeah,
that second shot just a little unconfident and drag his foot.
Rochester in a half-court trap. Hadley to Kiesling on the near side. Kiesling back to Hadley on the right wing. Back to Kiesling on the left side. Kiesling in the lane. Gives to Aldridge somehow. Aldridge backs his way in. Throws up a shot. It's good and a foul. Aldridge will go to the line to shoot a free throw. The lead is now 14 in favor of Cass with 7:09 to play in the game.
Alec Holland's third foul. Zebras 10th. So we're shooting two the rest of the way. This two-man game for Cass is just working very well. Kiesling penetrates and dumps off to Aldridge when the help comes.
Aldridge gets a bigger ovation for a made free throw than he does a basket. Then Kiesling steals the basketball, throws it up, it's good! Rochester will use a 60-second timeout, 7 minutes to play in the game. Cast up big, you're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
The important message you're about to hear is brought to you by your Culligan man. Is your water hard to live with? Are you tired of water that tastes bad, smells bad, leaves brown stains, and a hard water buildup on your shower walls and faucets? Are you tired of dry skin, dull hair, and dingy laundry? How about replacing appliances prematurely? Well, it's time to do something about it. Your Culligan man has the answer, a water treatment system from Culligan that can eliminate these problems for only $9.95 a month for the first 6 months. Call 574-223-2420 today for details. 574-223-2420 or visit CulliganFultonCounty.com. Culligan, better water, pure and simple.
What would you do if they put you in power? Would you make toll roads free or use the...
account subject to credit approval. Restrictions and limitations apply. BP Visa credit cards are issued by Chase Bank USA NA. See application located inside the station for pricing and rewards details. Purchases made at merchants where non-BP gasoline is sold do not earn rewards.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
7 minutes to play in the game. Lewis Cass leads 53-36. And Rochester, the basketball against a 2-2-1 press by the Kings. And then a ball stolen by Bixler, then stolen back by Korn. And then Seth Korn throws it to Ken Hughes.
Unfortunately, Ken's not in the lineup tonight. That's one where Seth, you've got 2-1. The big guy's back with Odell. You want to probably attack the big guy, make him come out a little more, then a bounce pass to John for a layup.
So Rochester in a half-court trap. Ball loose, picked up by Korn. Gives ahead to Odell. John Odell, jumper over Hadley off the glass is good.
That is John's first points of the half after scoring 19 in the first half.
Well, you were concerned about what was going to happen in the second half, as hot as he was in the first half because he answered the bell in the second half. Kiesling down low to Miller. His layup is good. 55-38. Kings on top with 6:10 to play in the game. Out of shell against the full court press by the Kings. Ahead to Korn. Korn against Aldridge. Reverse layup is off the bottom of the rim. No good. Odell picked up the loose ball rebound. He puts it in from 15 feet off the glass and cuts the lead to 15.
Good senior move by John. When your team's struggling, they need you in the fourth. You got to answer the call and get the team on your back.
Aldridge is fouled on the shot. He'll go to the line to shoot two with 5:52 to play in the game. Again, Kings up 55-40.
That foul's going to be on Seth Korn. It's going to be his third.
Cy Holland has two. He made that.
He made it.
Wow. Aldridge makes the second free throw of the night.
That's two in a row.
It's like two for seven or eight. One more coming for the big man. Ryan Aldridge, left-handed free throw on the way is good. No good.
Pulls
off the side of the rim. 56-40, Lewis Cass with 5:45 to play in the game. Streeton outside right, high on the right wing. Got a had a shell on the left side of the floor. Rochester going to our right, down by 16. To Garrick. Alec holds. Between his legs dribble. Down low, throws up a shot over Aldridge, it goes. Nice looking shot by Alec Garrick. And 56-42. Here comes the half-court trap.
7 points for Garrick.
Kiesling around Korn, jump pass to Miller. Miller takes one jump, one move to the inside, and then his shot is knocked away out of bounds by Rochester. It'll stay with the Kings baseline left.
Pretty impressive cast. Whatever the Zebras have thrown at him, they've always seemed to have an answer. They haven't gotten really rattled by anything. But, Kiesling out front, he just makes everything go. When he's calm, everybody else feeds off that.
Bixler with the basketball for the Kings. Zeta Hadley. Luke Kennedy will come back in after the next dead ball. Baseline to Miller. Miller is foul on the shot, no call. Kiesling, his putback is no good. And we get a foul coming on Rochester on the shot by Kiesling. And boy, I thought Aldridge Miller took a harder shot than Kiesling did there.
Yeah, of all the contact on that play, that was the least amount of contact, and that's the one that got called. That's Seth's fourth foul.
Austin Kiesling will go to the line to shoot two, looking to push this lead back to 16 with 5 minutes to play in the game.
The Zebras have been called for well over 20 fouls, and Cass has only been called for 8. Just saying.
We're at Rochester High School, by the way.
Just saying.
I hear what you're saying. Kennedy back in. Luke Korn make that. Seth Korn will sit down. 57-42, Lewis Cass. Kiesling with one more for his Kings from the charity stripe.
Kiesling, if he makes this,
he does not.
15 points for the youngster.
Odell with the board gives to Streeton. He's pretty quiet in the first half, yeah?
Kiesling, yeah. He didn't score at all in the first quarter, and he had 5 points in the second quarter. What grade is Kiesling in?
Junior. Rochester and Jake Hattischel call on a double dribble. So the team's going to get it back up. by 15 with 4:45 to play in the game. Lewis Cass faces the zone. Hadashell picks it off, gives it to Odell. He misses a layup. Jake Hadashell puts it back. It's good.
Hadashell's first point of the night.
57-44. An encouragement coming from Coach Reinhold as Kiesling picks his way through the defense, gives the finger roll in the lane. It goes.
That was easy. That kid's good. You put him, put him in the middle against that trap. Once he gets the ball, he just made every right decision he could so far tonight.
Hadashell in the corner to Odell for three, right side, no good. And Miller grabs the board for Lewis Cass, gives to Bixler. 4 minutes to play in the game, 15-point lead for the Kings. Hadley breaks the press, or breaks the half-court trap to Kiesling to wide-open Miller. His shot off the window is good.
You know, it also helps against beating a trap is, you know, when you put the two big guys on the baseline, you can just kind of throw it up there, yeah. Let them go get it. That helps, too.
30-second timeout taken by the Zebras. You're listening to Rochester Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
At Smith, Sawyer, and Smith Insurance Agency of Rochester, they know anything can happen at any given time without notice. They also know that finding the right insurance for the right price is really pretty easy. That's why they are your local trusted choice agent, which means they have access to multiple insurance companies that offer competitive pricing and coverage. Call 574-223-2166 or stop by their downtown location at 124 East 8th Street. You can also visit them online at smithsawyerins.com. Since 1932, Smith Sawyer Smith Insurance has protected individuals and families from those unforeseeable events in life.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
3 minutes, 51 seconds to play in the game. Lewis Cass up 61-44. The Kings will stay in that 2-2-1 press. Rochester Zebras with the basketball going to our right. Hadashell gets it across the timeline. Now to Streeton. 3:43 to play in the game. Tony Stasiak, I'm David Musselman. This thing was tied at halftime. And Lewis Cass kind of pulled away. Garrick drives the baseline and travels before he puts the ball on the floor.
Looking to make that baseline move. He's been pretty good at it this year, but just started to move before he had full possession, got out of control, and moved a little too quick, drug that foot.
3.5 to play in the game, 61-44 Kings. In the corner to Aldridge. Aldridge on the baseline, outside to Kiesling. No look pass to Miller. Wow, how about that look by Kiesling?
Man,
that pass was more impressive than that. And then the steal by Kiesling. His layup is to Hadley. Is good, the foul. Kiesling steals the basketball, gives to a cutting Hadley. He's hacked in the act, and he'll go to the line for one.
Talk about turning it on. Like we said, at halftime, Kiesling had 5 points.
Number 20, Carter Street.
He has 17 now. And his assists have almost been as impressive as the shots.
He's had two nice assists on the last two possessions for the Kings. And now they're up by 21 points. And Hadley looks to stretch to 22. And he does so with a freebie. Allman back into the game and Bixler to sit for the Kings. 3:10 to play in the basketball game. Kings up 66-44 here at Rochester High School. Streeton on the wing, just dribbles, gives to Hadashell, high on the left side. Jacob, one dribble, dives down low to Kennedy, outside to Streeton. Streeton to Hadashell, now to Cy Holland in the paint. His jumper over Aldridge is no good. Kennedy with the rebound, the putback is good.
Luke's fifth point of the night.
66-46, Lewis Cass with 2:45 to play in the game. Hadley brings it up against Hadashell, and now the ball stolen by Kennedy, who gives ahead to Cy Holland. Holland, top of the key, holds and looks for Garrick, gets him on the right wing. Lewis Cass in that 2-3 zone with 2:25 to play in the game. The Kings by 20, and Hadashell travels, drags a foot and travels.
Still kind of feeling out process, learning where everybody's at on the floor.
Lewis Cass will take a 30-second timeout. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
For profit or not for profit, it may not seem like it matters. However, if you're selecting a hospice organization, it can make all the difference in the world. At Hope Hospice, we are a not-for-profit, public benefit healthcare option. All of our focus can freely be given to our clinical services and the nurses that tend directly to your loved one's needs. We do not have to worry about cutting costs or running minimally staffed programs in order to profit someone else. Our only concern is how well our patients are cared for. When selecting a hospice organization, select Hope Hospice at 224 Hope or visit us online at hopehospicefce.com.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
2:24 to play in the game. Lewis Cass up by 20 at 66-46. And after the Kings timeout, they will have the basketball going to our left. Our next broadcast here on WROI will be Tuesday night as the Rochester Lady Zebras host the Oregon Davis Lady Bobcats.
Yep.
You can hear that game here on WROI. Brad and I will have that one. You'll be busy, huh?
Might be. Hopefully.
Jake. Hopefully so. Aldrin in the baseline. Now to Kiesling and Lewis Cass looking like they'll take the air out of the basketball here. Baseball pass to Aldridge. What do I know? He'll go in for the layup. It's no good. And then we're going to have a foul on Aldridge, who misses a bunny. I'm talking less than, I'm not sure if you can get less than 2 feet, but he was closer than 2 feet. But I think maybe he was thinking about maybe laying that in or just dunking it.
Yeah, you could tell. I mean, he was so wide open. That's the most space he's had to shoot the ball all night and wasn't used to it either.
And as active as he's been on the board, that's only his first foul.
Yeah, I mean, very impressed with him and Kiesling both. What a great 1-2 punch to have for the Cass Kings.
A minute 50 to play in the game. Lewis Cass up 66-46. And Rochester, the basketball outside right to Streeton. The Zebras are going to our right and lay to Houdeshell. Down low to Kennedy. Reverse layup is good. Nice job by Luke Kennedy. Gets 7 points.
Once again, when Luke's on the floor, he produces.
Yeah. 66-48. Hadley outside for the Kings. Now to Kiesling with 90 seconds to play. Now to Hadley. Back to Kiesling. I played this game before. It's called Monkey in the Middle. They kind of got keep away to Aldridge. Aldridge kicks it outside to Hadley. Gives it to Kiesling high on the right side of the minute 20 to play in the game. Kane's going to move their mark to 4-3. Rochester's going to slip to 1-5. A minute 10 to play in the basketball game. Lewis Cass up by 18. Kiesling, no look pass in the corner to Miller. Sends it to the near side to Hadley. In the corner to Oman. Back to Kiesling near the timeline. And Coach Kitchell will use a timeout to get some of his kids in the game. 60-second timeout. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
When it comes to buying a home, you can draw on the experience of the mortgage lenders at First Federal Savings Bank. Since 1966, First Federal has provided financing to homeowners throughout the area. First Federal is locally owned, so loan approvals are made here and loan servicing is done in your hometown. Free pre-qualifications are available at First Federal Savings Bank, 301 East 9th in Rochester and 814 North US 35 in Winnemac. Offices are also in Plymouth, Bremen, Elkhart, and Mishawaka. First Federal is FDIC insured and an equal housing lender. Borrowers must meet underwriting guidelines and a delivery fee may be applied to the loan. NMLS 399927.
Paint in half the time with new paint and primer in one from Clark & Kensington. Available exclusively at Ace. You'll get top quality, easy to use paint and help that can only come from your neighborhood Ace. People who know their stuff will be right there to help you pick the perfect shade from Clark & Kensington's harmonious color palette, so you can get your weekend back with Clark and Kensington's paint and primer in one, exclusively at Ace, the helpful place. You can find all of your Ace paints at Smith Farm Stores of Rochester and Plymouth.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
Back at Rochester High School, the Lewis Cass Kings can basically clear the bench and bring in some substitutes as they lead by 18 points with under a minute to play in the game. And Odell steals the basketball, gives to Kennedy, ahead to Screen, and stays it going out of bounds right in the hands of Bixler and Lewis Cass. Now ahead to Hadley. Hadley across the timeline with 45. In the corner to Oman. Oman against the double team is going to be fouled, and that's going to send the Kings to the free throw line for two free throws, and Alec Eric just fouled out.
I don't believe this is the first game he's fouled out. But that is his fifth foul.
Number 10, Owen. Owen. Shooting two.
They're shooting free throws, and Garrick has fouled out. So Seth Corn back in the game. So Jack Rupley, the official here at Rochester, is jawing with Rex Reinholdt. They're jawing back and forth. And in the meantime, the official gives the ball to Oman, who shoots the first free throw and misses. So now, was that a free throw shot, or does he get two now?
It was a shot. I mean, the other official let him have it. Yeah.
Second one is good. 67-48, 40 seconds playing the game.
Jeez.
Odell, long threes, no good. Oman then tips the basketball out of bounds. It'll stay with Rochester underneath their own basket with 31 seconds to play in the game. Ty Holland, baseline right, looks to trigger it in. Now Seth Korn will do the gut. 67-48, Lewis Cass. Luke Kennedy grabs the inbounds pass, shoots it, no good, gets the rebound back, puts it back up, no good. Sancha makes that to DeJesus, comes out of there with it, and gives the head to Hadley with 20. It's a 19-point lead in favor of the Kings. The ball stolen away by Korn with 15 and gives to Odell with 13.
Good thing he finished with one more bucket.
And now we're going to have a foul on Lewis Cass, which is only the team's fifth with 10.6 to play in the ball game.
Team's only their 10th foul of the game.
Wow.
In our 23. Ish.
10.6 to play in the game. Rochester down by 29. And the inbounds pass is stolen by Bixler. Bixler across the timeline with 7, and that'll do it. Lewis Cass is going to defeat Rochester here on their home floor, 67-48. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.